Astrology is a limb of Veda. So if you separate a person's eyes, or if you amputate a person's legs, how it can function? The beauty of the eye is it needs presence with the face. And the efficacy of a person's legs will not be unless it is associated with the body and its mobility. So a person should be knowing Vedas, at least some portions of Vedas. If the person loses connection with the main switch, then in spite of the perfection in the various tools and equipments, we cannot get the desired result. That is avaidhika. And the second thing is anachara. They are not, even though they are not associated with Vedas, even in food, even in practice, in upasana, all of these things they fail. So anupasaka, they don't contemplate, they don't have any deity, they don't have any mantra, they don't have any spiritual practice. Then anachara is eating everything, eating anything, eating everywhere. Then doing all sorts of these unwanted prohibitions which are there, even substandards for even a believer of God. If an astrologer, astrologer is in Shastra known as Daivajna, one who knows the will of God. Why it is known as Jyotisha? For three reasons, innumerable reasons we have stated earlier. For example, each and every person's life is darkness. If you are there inside a dark room, you cannot do anything. So your future is a mystery, it is a dark room. So as Jyotisha is a candle in the dark room of future, it is known as Jyotisha. Bhavishyat sarvatra tibiravat abhidhiyate tatra yathartha jnana pradhanataya Jyotirvat bhavyate sarvajnaihi iti Jyotisham iti idam shastram abhidhiyate. The shastra is known as Jyotisha. The shastra is known as Jyotisha because it serves as a candle. And second thing, even though you might be having a book, a manual with bold letters and with voluminous editions of knowledge, unless you have proper light to see that, you cannot see that. So the world is having a lot of messages, how this globe has come into existence, how it is being conducted. So there are a lot of cosmic principles, there are a lot of global principles, and there is a very beautiful internet access for understanding each and everything. There is a global consciousness project at Princeton University. If something has happened there, immediately that has a reflection on site. And a Chinese proverb says the same, you cannot pluck a flower without disturbing a distant star. But the disturbance may be very infinitesimal. We are all well connected. That connection can be understood only by Jyotisham. Vyaktigata Jyotisham is entirely different. If you are practicing for a particular person, his marriage, his education, his promotion, that is different. Astrology as a science, astronomy as a total science, it is very difficult for us to understand. Somebody should ask them, we are at the earth, and what is the role of Mars? Where is Mars? Where is Jupiter? We must understand that each and every solar family, a human body, and the functions, that is Satta, Sthiti, Pravritti, existence, sustenance and action of all of the species are tangibly governed by the earthly elements and certainly governed by the other extra geospatial elements. For example, even though you are at earth, you are having matrimonial desire, you are having taste in knowledge, taste in fine arts, as a musician, everything said, that is controlled by Venus. So you are having Jupiterian, satanical, martial and various instincts embedded inside at the time of your garbhasamskara. Whenever a person's soul was destined to assume a body in the earth, immediately we are having a conglomerated participation of the energy limit of each and every member of the solar family. Just as seven members of a family like father, mother, brother, sister, everybody, they take care of a newborn shishu or a particular shishu, babe. Then we are all the children of the earth, and it is duty of this Pitta, that is a Shum Pranik Prasave, that is why he is known as Surya. And Surya is like the father, and he must nourish with the other members of the solar family that they are governing us. So this must be understood as a global concept worldwide. So Jyotisha serves as a lantern which makes us to understand the inscriptions of nature and its beauty more. Third thing is Jyoti means eye. Without having eye, you cannot see anything. You can see God, you can see the wonder in God's creation, you can see as a reflection mirror our own sins and virtues only through Jyotisha. See, you are seeing you in a mirror. In advanced mirror like X-ray or multi-level digital scanning, you are seeing the real splendor inside. You are seeing the inner parts. Can you see the inner parts through your mirror? There is a different mirror. So likewise, you are having mirror for the outer parts. You are having photo and everything for the outermost parts. You are having scanning and everything for the inner parts. You are having astrology as a jyoti for the innermost parts. So it is known as Jyotisha. These are the three exemplifications given. Then let us come to this final end. I have already told Avaidhikatva, Anupasakatva, Anachara. Anachara is very much dangerous to the society. These are the various reasons by which the astrologers, they cannot compete with real talent, with real skill, with the atheist so-called rationals and scientists. Such a person, such a single person must come as a dawn or for a boon for the whole astrological society, and we must continuously be engaged in the task of creating such a person and organizing a person and organizing the person to evince himself in the society so as the greatest glory of astrology is installed. Then there are two types of shodhana in astrology. One is known as naimittika, second is known as kamya. Just as you are frequently testing your pressure and sugar and other things as per your age, whenever you are having some circumstances, we have to go for astrological prediction or astrological guidelines. It is known as naimittika. What are the naimittika vatavarana or the backgrounds? Janma. Vidyabhyasa. Janma means birth status. Second is Vidyabhyasa means career consultancy and counseling. That must be started at the age of 7. Not after completing, selecting some faculty, then completing everything, then asking what to do. It is not a proper way. That is early for the next birth. So, Vidyabhyasa. Third thing is Udvahana, matrimonial match. Then Vanijya. Then Ayubhanga, vipat or accidents. Then the sixth thing is whenever we are seeing something which is inexplicable by ourselves, that is known as Agochara Kheda. Wherever we are facing Vyadhi, Kshaya, Durbhiksha, Mantra, Yantra, Tantra, Astra, Shastra, Visha, Vichara and Shunya, various other evil and perilous factors, irrationally, which cannot be designed, directed and detected by any methodologies of survey and search in the modern society. When such occasions occur, for understanding the real meaning and background of these things, we are going for an astrological guidance. So these things are known as kamya. Naimittika means occasional checkup of our horoscope with people. Let me start and give two examples. One is in Shishupati. Shishupati, there are a lot of questions. What is Sayonitva? What is Vyonitva? What is Sodara Sayonitva? Or Anudara Sayonitva, Anudara Vyonitva? There are innumerable such calculations. For example, Vyoni, at the same time, a dog is yielding its puppy and a king is giving his own son, the royal prince, and a beggar is also giving his own contribution as a junior beggar to the world. So this is known as Anudara Sayoni. They are not from the same belly, from the same womb, but they are all of the Sayoni. They are homogeneity in nature. And when compared to that of this dog and human being, it is Vyoni and Anudara. Even in Sodara, in the same belly, we see lot of twins and multiples. Even Gandhari, it is believed that she had 100 children. So how to interpret these things? This can be interpreted only by Siddhi, and there is no sutra or kriti for all of these things. These can be very much smelt and understood only by Siddhi. So there are some gaps which are given in astrology, which believes that you are not the master of destiny, you are servant of destiny. There is one person known as God, you have to surrender and learn. For giving this instruction, stipulation or admonishment, God has given lot of gaps. Just as it has been told by a very famous cosmopolitan, the world is a very beautiful thing. All the wonders and splendors of the world are kept inside the safe. It has a lock and it has a key. But the problem is the key itself is inside the safe. So based on these things, the Shishupati, apart from the Sodhara, Anudhara, Sayoni, Vyoni, etc., there is one Shastra Shishu now. Shastra Shishu is known as the Sicilian Zeri. There is no horoscope for Sicilian Zeri. See, whatever is Yadrichikam Shakunam Nimittam Uchyate. If accidentally something crosses you, if you hear something, that is known as Shakuna or Nimitta. If you are bringing somebody and if you are creating its own thing, where is Yadrikachitva? It must happen on its own. Whenever it is induced by you, the precision of its natural inclination or propriety is disturbed. So for all Caesarean babies are having a very great blessing that they are horoscopeless. There are only two people in the world, or two entities in the world who have no horoscope at all. One is the God, second is the sincere and deep.